Noah's Garrett. That was well after the play. And here it is. He tackled Rudolph. Rudolph didn't like the way that he was tackled.
Oh, my goodness.
Rips the helmet off Rudolph's head and then eventually swings it and hits him in the head. And then Ogunjobi comes up and hits Rudolph from behind.
Beyond words,
Joe. Oh, gosh, that's one of the worst things I've ever seen on a professional sports field.
You know, Joe, I've been involved with these in the league office, and it would come to officiating first and then go upstairs for discipline, but this is beyond the normal discipline. This is beyond the normal fine. I think you're absolutely right. It's a foul period to take a guy's helmet off and swing it and use it as a weapon. Automatic ejection by rule. But it goes beyond that now to possible suspension. Of course, then Pouncey was a Pouncey that was kicking and throwing the punches. That's another one.
They're absolutely. I mean, this is multiple game suspension right here. It's just. I mean, I hate that anybody even has to watch this. This is barbaric, is what this is.
Still the. So what they're doing now, by the way, is talking to New York, because New York can look at this whole skirmish. And they can now pick the players that should be disqualified from the game and even create fouls that aren't called. That were obviously there were quite a few called. But they can look who was involved with the fight, who threw punches, who swung helmets, who kicked, and can add on, which means more discipline to come, either in fines or suspension.
Seconds left in this game, and that's what everybody's walking away from this Thursday night game with. It's horrible, and these two teams meet again in 17 days. Let's think what that's going to be like. And see Mike Tomlin saying, Mason, you're out. Mason Rudolph's left hand was caught in the helmet somehow of Myles Garrett, and that's why he was trying to go to the headgear the way that he was. I don't know, but wow. It's been such a great game and a great win for this Cleveland franchise is not what anybody's going to be talking about since October of 2014 against the Steelers, but talk about leaving with a horrible taste in your mouth. Thankfully, Rudolph's okay and able to stay in there, so if Tomlin was saying you're out, it's fourth down here, by the way. Rudolph stays
in. Another snap. It was fourth down, so he took a knee, and so we've got a change of possession, so we now have to clear everybody off the field and take one more snap.
Looked like Freddie Kitchens was just saying, hey, just let it run, let's go, this game is over, but that's unfortunately not the way that it works. The Steelers, at least the offensive players are leaving. Baker Mayfield in this game with a couple of touchdown passes, a touchdown run. The Browns with four interceptions in the ballgame. And the offense for Cleveland's now gone three straight games without a turnover. Running back Nick Chubb ends up with 92 yards. He's over 1,000 yards for the game. Joe Schobert, 10 tackles, 2 tackles for a loss, a sack, 4 passes defensed, and 2 interceptions. And somehow the officials have been able to get everybody off the field, so there's one more snap, and then we'll hear what everybody has to say after this one. 7 is the final here tonight in Cleveland. The Browns are now at 4-6. The Steelers' 4-game winning streak is over. They're 5-5. As week number 11 is underway, the big news is how this game just ended. And Aaron Andrews is with Baker Mayfield right now.
Baker, and I'm asking about it. What was your reaction as you were watching it unfold?
I didn't see why it started, but it's inexcusable. I don't care, rivalry or not, we can't do that. That's kind of the history of, you know, what's been going on here lately, hurting yourself, and that's just endangering the other team. That's inexcusable. He knows that. I hope he does now. It's tough. We'll see.
Mason Rudolph, a friend of yours, Myles Garrett, a teammate of yours. What were you saying to your teammates over there to kind of calm everybody down?
I don't think there's anything in that moment that I can really say to calm him down. You know what? The reality is he's going to get suspended. We don't know how long, and that hurts our team. And we can't do that. We can't continue to hurt this team. That's inexcusable.
Moving forward, you do get the win tonight. I mean, despite obviously ending the game like that, and this is what you said. You wanted to finish the second half of the season strong. What can you build off of what you were able to do offensively?
We still didn't play good enough at all. You know, it came out and had a great first drive, and then, you know, kind of sputtered out a little bit. We have to be able to capitalize, and defense gets that many turnovers. It's just, we'll look at the film. We got to get better from that. Offensively, it's still not even close to being good enough.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Well, a very